Hello there, in the previous video we have configured BGP on these links here, between these two peers actually, and we've also configured P under the PE's AES override to actually advertise routes from the same AES number. Now, in this part, we're actually going to achieve this, so only the loopback ones should be advertised between sites. Loopbacks 2 and 3 should be filtered, and we should use site of origin in order to achieve that. But before jumping into the configuration part, let me briefly describe how site of origin works. So let's say we have an iBGP session here between R3 and R4. And let's say that CE3 advertises a prefix learned from here, let's say prefix X. It advertises it to router 15. 15 advertises it to router 16. 16 advertises to CE4 because we've configured it with AS override and it returns the traffic back in the AS. And CE3 will advertise it back, CE4 will advertise it back to CE3. So the actual data plane, if let's say CE3 receives traffic destined to X, it will send it through this interface and traffic would flow like this and it should be sent here to X. But what happens if now CE3 doesn't prefer this route here to X towards that neighbor, let's say, but it prefers this path? Well, in this case, if any of these, let's say CE3 wants to send traffic destined to X, it will actually prefer this path, so it will send traffic through this path. Traffic reaches CE4. CE4 has this best route to through R16, and again we take the same path and traffic reaches CE3 again. CE3 checks again what BGP route does it prefer. It prefers the BGP route from CE4 and again sends the traffic to CE4, and you can see it's quite obvious that we've formed a loop here between CE3 and CE4, and this was because we did have a backdoor link and also the AES override feature configured on the PEs. There's a mechanism to prevent these kind of loops even when we have AES override configured, and it just works like this. So you do assign, so let's say again that we have this backdoor link, even though it doesn't really matter. You go on these PE nodes and assign a site of origin value for the neighbor. So it's under the neighbor, the configuration. And let's say that we're assigning 1, 2, 3, 4, and 10. And we do this on both PEs towards the neighbors of the same VRF. And each neighbor will have this local value configured. Now, how this actually works is when CE3 sends a BGP route, let's say, sends a prefix X, when router 15 sends this BGP prefix to router 16, it also attaches that site of origin value, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. R16 checks the site of origin value, and what it does is it will ignore the neighbors that have the same site of origin value. So this neighbor has the same SOO value, so it will not advertise this route to him. And that's how it works. So you check the site of origin and ignore, don't advertise this prefix X to any neighbors that have this site of origin configured under them. But I actually, now it's getting a bit more complicated because The task says that loopback 1 between these two sites should be advertised, but only loopback 2 and 3 should not be advertised. If we do assign site of origin, the same site of origin value, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, this will get attached to every prefix. So if CE3 advertises loopback 1, 2 and 3, when router 15 advertises loopback 1, 2 and 3 of CE3 to router 16, it attaches this site of origin value to all these routes. And based on this, router 6 will not advertise any of these routes to CE4, so this doesn't happen. We need somehow to filter based on the prefix list, and what we'll actually do is the following. So we're going to assign different site of origin values for each of these links, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 right here, and we're matching to only set here on router 15. We're setting this site of origin only for loopback 2 and 3. But pay attention, we're not going, and this is quite strange, we're not going to attach 1, 2, 3 for and 3, because if we advertise to router 6 routes with 1, 2, 3, 4, dash, not dash, but colon 3, these will get passed through, because 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3 is different than 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4, and it's not violating this rule that you shouldn't advertise to a neighbor with the same site of origin values. But what we'll actually do is that we're going to set here on router 15 this site of origin. So we're setting for loopback 2 and loopback 3 of CE3, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4. So now when 15 advertises to 16 loopbacks 2 and 3 with 1, 2, 3, 4, colon 4, this matches the local site of origin statement for the neighbor, and we won't advertise these two loopbacks anymore. Hopefully you got it. Maybe watch again this video if you didn't. But now I'm just going to jump to the configuration part. I'm not going to show you the first example, so the traditional way. This is quite a strange way, to be honest, to implement site of origin, but in the CCISP lab exam you might be presented with everything, so I'm just going to implement this, the strange method. Okay, let's make this quite a bit more smaller, and let's go ahead. So I've said that we're going on router 15, and first of all we're going to set SOO ending with 3 for CE3, and this is done like this. So under router BGP 100, it's 10, router BGP 10, BRF Pepsi, neighbor 10.3.15.3, address family IPv4 unicast, site of origin 1.2.3.4.1.2.3.4.3, and this is quite straightforward. Let me commit this and see that the routes received by router 16 do have this site of origin attached to them. This is actually an extended community, so it's nothing strange. Show BGP VRF Pepsi 3.3.3.1/32, and bum 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 bum. I don't see it yet. But yeah, okay, now it is attached, and that's the AS decibel notation. And we see that this got attached. Let me do something similar on router 16, but now we're attaching the site of origin with this last byte ending in 4. So 10.4.16.4. And if we just wait a bit, we'll see these routes with a different, okay, it's already here. So we do know that this comes from site 4 and this comes from site 3. So now what I need to do is to actually advertise loopbacks 2 and 3 of 3.3.3.1 with site of origin ending in 4, so that CE4 won't receive them anymore. So let's see how we learn those routes. So show BGP ERF Pepsi 3.3.3.2 and 3.3.3.3. Okay. And we're advertising these towards CE4 because we have the SO ending in 4 attached, configured for this CE4 neighbor. And we'll actually do that with route policy. So let's start here. It goes like this. So first you need to configure the extended community set, and it's like this, and you just put the value here and set, and then a route policy set SOO. If destination in 3, I'll use this for somehow reverse logic. So if destination is in 3.3.3.1, so destination is 3.3.3.1, then pass. Actually, I also need to put else. If not, so what it remains 3.3.3.2 and 3.3.3.3 set extended community SOO4 and if and policy, and let's actually apply this inbound on this to run formal include 10.3.15.3, and we'll apply it here on the inbound from our customer. So here, route policy set SOO inbound. And if we check again, these two routes, 3.3.3.2 and 3.3.3.3, we'll see a change in the site of origin value. Actually, why is it still here? Maybe we'll need to clear the BGP session. Actually, no, it's okay because we still have, yeah, okay. Over on router BGP, we still have this statement here. And with together with the route policy, these add up somehow. But why? Because they shouldn't, because I didn't use the additive feature. So set SOO, it's an extended command. With route targets, you would actually need to put here the additive keyword to actually here the additive keyword to also keep the previous route targets, but I see that this is different with site of origin, and I'm actually not sure why it's like that. And somehow it looks like it does send both of these. To be honest, I didn't know about this behavior, because usually site of origin isn't implemented like this. But anyway, we do achieve what we wished, so we're only advertising 3.3.3.1 from router 16 because 3.3.3.1 contains only this site of origin. So this is 3.3.3.1. Let me clear the BGP sessions just in case, but I'm 99% sure that's going to remain the same. But just in case, let's clear these. And in the meanwhile, let's work on this second policy on R16 this time. So on 16, we're setting 3 for routes 4.4.4.2 and 4.4.4.3. So like this. Set should be called, yep, so also show run formal include 10.16 and here run policy inbound. Actually, the name is set SOO inbound. And let's do some checks because of so BGP VRF Pepsi. This one has only this attached, and the others two will be the same, only with 4 attached, and this one also. Let's check again here. Do show BGP VRF Pepsi if anything changed for what we've done previously, and no, we still have both of these attached, and it seems like it's the expected behavior. I don't know about that, maybe you should investigate further. I will also do maybe after this video. So now after I will commit this configuration for that on router 16, for that, for that, for that 3 and for that, for that, for that 2. We'll also have the SOO handing int 3 attached. So let me just double check what I'm committing and let me commit it. And after this, we won't see these BGP routes on CE3 anymore. And it's already done. And you can actually verify by pinging from CE1 loopback 2 of 4.4.4.2. So this is reachable. And also router 3s. So we can reach these loopbacks from other sites, but we can't reach them from CE3 to CE4. So if we do a ping here, this will fail because we're filtering loopback 2 and loopback 3 of these two CEs. And maybe you may ask yourself, why is this still reachable from CE1? Because we don't have any loop prevention mechanisms on router 11. So if we go again over this example, we are attaching 1, 2, 3, let's say 3 for loopback 2. And this is sent to the route reflector and reflected to R11, and R11 receives this route. It's 4.4.4.2. And it also has this site of origin value attached, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3. And no one cares about this. We never mentioned any SOOs on router 11, so this prefix just gets advertised to CE1. We have OSPF here. We don't care about the BGP loop prevention mechanism. Okay, then, that's it for the site of origin. Next, we're going to see the additional paths implementation, but we're going to do that in a separate video.